headed in the right direction, having that new map, having that map support, having people working together. We're headed in the right direction. And the nice thing about using the same program for multiple years, we as teachers are getting much more efficient and just know the program. So that's really the news. And as you can see, ELA, we, as a district, we continue to be above the state average at Central and at the district. So kudos to everyone for all their hard work. Anyone have any questions for me?
Just thank you, ladies, for, I mean, even all the teachers, too. There's been such transition this year with the school coming together. I feel like you're just doing amazing.
Thank you.
And the pictures, too, you can tell.
And your hair blowers work really well.
Yeah, good.
All right, superintendent's report. Many of you may know, but you may not, the Michigan Department of Ed started a parent dashboard this year as a mentor for parents, families to look at how schools compare with other schools and how your district's doing against, and you can compare it with the like demographics, local schools, however you want to compare them. The House Education Reform Committee is already talking about changing that, so this is the first year for it, and changing it from a dashboard to letter grades. Representative Kelly has been wanting letter grades for schools for quite some time, so I would say overall there's a great possibility that that could change again. It would be on separate metrics, not an overall letter grade for a school. Or a school district. Does that make sense? So all the different parts of the metric, letter grade, no cumulative grade. The resolution that was passed by this board at the last board meeting that this board supported unanimously to not have guns in schools has been shelved, at least for now. Obviously we had another tragic incident in Florida not long ago, and frankly, that's the reason it's shelved for now. The national walkout against school violence is slated for March 14th. Misinformation out there about either a building's perspective or the district's perspective. We're going to support our kids if that's what they would like to do. It's again, as I said, March 14th. We would certainly use it as a learning opportunity, teaching and learning opportunity for our students. It is not a district directed walkout. It'll be, if students would like to do this, they will work with our staff to do it in a safe and orderly way, but certainly to support the 17 minutes for the 17 tragic deaths in Florida. So just to get accurate information out there, we will support our students if that's what they choose to do. Recent law that has the potential to affect finances in the county. Legislation was passed that charters, public school charters, will now get a piece of enhancement revenues. So when it's time to, assuming that it gets back on the ballot for the enhancement millage for the county, not effective retroactively, it's only effective if a new millage passes. So just so you know, when we get to that place a couple years down the road, that would dilute the dollars to the point. Questions, comments?
What's the rationale for that?
I know Representative Kelly, who has a lot of weight in Lindsay, been there for a long time, and it's a second stint in Lansing. every student, regardless of where they go, should get the same amount of dollars. As an example, in the governor's budget, he's proposing 75% funding for virtual schools. Since they don't have transportation, they don't have buildings, they have much larger student-teacher ratios. And he is adamantly opposed to that. Every student should get the same amount, even though we know, like K-12 Inc. is the largest virtual school company in the nation, they're paying shareholders. So if you look at their model historically, their cost per pupil are significantly different than traditional public school. So it goes back to, shouldn't matter where the child goes to school, the same money should follow.
The agenda, business agenda. I will take a motion on the trip request for the high school students, DECA state competition in Detroit as per repertoire.
I move that we take action on the high school student DECA state competition in Detroit as a repertoire.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. I'll take a motion for the High School Students Michigan Association of Student Council State Conference in Grand Rapids for reference to.
I'll make a motion to approve the High School Students Michigan Association of Students Council State Conference in Grand Rapids for reference to.
Support.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Take a motion for the High School Students Health Occupation Studies of America, HOSA State Leadership Conference in Grand Rapids for reference 3.
I make a motion that we approve the High School Students Health Occupation Studies of America, HOSA State Leadership Conference in Grand Rapids.
Support.
Any discussion?
Do we have any of our own students that go to this one, or is it?
We do. This year, Evan Weesey's, Jillian Jakeway's, Tyler Hampton, and Michaela Greenberg will be going representing her.
Nice.
And just includes the dental, this is the one that includes the dental.
And that's
dental,
including dental.
Okay. Any more? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Good. I'll take a motion to approve the action on policy matters. First reading approval of NEOLA policies for reference 4.
I move that we approve the action on policy matters. First reading of the NEOLA policies, reference 4.
Support.
That is a roll call vote.
Michelle Ammons?
Yes.
Annette Sorensen?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Sherry Ballmer?
Yes.
Dodie Leckie?
Yes.
John Madras?
Yes.
Jennifer Miller?
Yes.
Rhonda Newman?
Yes.
Opportunity for comments from the audience on the board regarding non-agenda. First one I have is Melissa Lynn.
Hi. All right, first of all, I want to thank teachers, staff, principals. If you've had one or both of my girls, you guys have really helped them, and especially with Skylar, you guys have really shaped how she is today.
Second of all, I want to give a huge shout out and thanks to Mr. Meisner for the phone call last week regarding the fire alarm trip, because Skylar was kind of freaking out about it. And I think as a parent, especially with recent things that have been going on, I really appreciated that. So thank you. So that brings me to my question for you guys. With the recent events that have been going on, whether it's Ms. Hemming or Mr. Meisner or the high school principal, what do we have in place to secure the safety for not only our teachers, the staff, and everybody, but for our students? I mean, is there any training in place? Do you guys have anything that you guys are thinking about bringing to the attention of the staff?
Well, every building has protocols.
Right.
Every building practices protocols. We don't share them because we don't want others to know what they are.
Right. I understand that, but I just wanted, as far as the situation, I mean, I'm not saying that I don't feel that my kids aren't safe, because I feel that they are completely safe at least the school district. But at any point in time, all it does is take one kid just to sneak a weapon into their backpack. As far as that goes, I mean, do you guys have safety protocols as far as that, or how to even alert us parents when something like that does happen?
We do. And probably the most important thing is parents and staff, for any potential threat to our kids and staff, is to be present. Especially in the mornings and after school, that people are aware of who's out here.
Well, and then that also brings me to my third question is, as far as a child, whether they're in kindergarten, I know it's kind of wonky, especially with lower L, because they're going through a lot of mental changes, but starting in middle school and high school, do you guys know warning signs of any mental illness? I mean, is everybody properly trained?
I would say yes.
All right, well, thank you.
The next green card is Winter. You can mute it, Sanderson.
Sorry. I just want to first of all say, I think congratulations. Don't we have a contract?
We do.
So, yay! Why hasn't this been celebrated? Like, seriously, it was, because after the last meeting, I was so angry, because I felt like it was still like this one side versus the other side. And it went to the point where I came home and Maggie asked me, whose side are you on, Mommy? And I was like, I'm sorry, you know I'm gonna get emotional, this is me. But I just said, Maggie, I am on the kid's side. And she said, well, whose side is that? And I had to tell her, I don't know. That's what I felt. I was so mad after the last meeting, because I didn't know. I was so, I don't know. I went from the point where I'm friends with so many of you and so many of you, and I would talk to you and I'd get a totally different answer than what I'd get from all of these people. And okay, so before I left tonight, Luke and William are fighting, and I get Luke's side of the story and I get William's side of the story, and somewhere in the middle there's the truth. But I felt like I was getting this side of the story and this side of the story, and there was no meshing. And I was like, who's lying to me? Why, I look like a jerk, because when I go to talk to my friends over here, they'd be like, that's not true. They're lying to you. And then I talk to my friends over here and they'd say, that's not true. They're lying to you. So I just was very disappointed in that. And I don't know. I believe in, my point is I believe in all of you from that. And from, I didn't know what to do about that. I don't know, I don't understand how the answers could be so extremely different from one side to the other. And it doesn't really matter anymore what the truth is, because, well, I mean, it does matter. But my point is that it doesn't matter in each situation. It's just like, why was it so, I don't understand why it was so hard to come to a common ground in it, you know? I'm sorry, I totally lost my place and tried to see what I'm saying, but I just felt like, you know, I was disappointed in the board that the teachers felt like they couldn't speak without being reprimanded. I heard that from many people, but at the same time, I felt like people said that I wasn't speaking up, or that the board wasn't telling me something because I was afraid that I was going to be reprimanded by the board, or my kids were going to be treated differently. And I don't care, because if you really want to treat my wonderful children differently, then that's your problem, because they don't deserve that. But I know you wouldn't do that. And that's what I don't understand where that, I don't understand where everybody's, why we couldn't get along with this whole thing. This community is amazing. I was recently asked what I wanted to do when I grew up, like if I knew as a child, and I heard somebody say, oh, I had no idea what I wanted to do. I wrote a book when I was in second grade that I wanted to go to the University of Michigan. I wanted to be a labor and delivery nurse, and then I wanted to have 12 kids. We stopped at 4, but with all the kids that I've coached in different things and everything I do, I mean, there's so many of these kids that I see everywhere now that I consider my, you know, kids that I would say I've accomplished all three of those goals. My point is that, and this is for my teachers, because I love you all, that I knew when I was going to be a nurse or a mom or go to U of M that it was going to be hard. That being a nurse, you were going to work 12-hour shifts. You were going to maybe have to work and get mandated extra shifts. And that you were going to have some of the hardest times ever as a nurse. Maybe some of the most disappointing, emotional, very sad times as a nurse. But I also knew that it would be some of the most amazing times when moms would see that baby for the first time. And I'm just telling you that part of the story because I'm pretty sure that when you all signed up to be teachers, you did not sign up to do it because it was going to be the highest paid profession. I bet you knew that you would have tests to grade and things to do after hours. Not that we should settle for any of that. I'm not saying that we should settle for being the lowest, or not the lowest, but a lowest, lower paid profession. But I also knew that you'd have difficult situations and families to deal with. I mean, maybe not as crazy as some of these days are, but that you would. But you would also be the part of some of the most life-changing things. These kids love you. I have seen so many of you do so many things for these kids that if you don't feel valued, come to me. I've got a story for every single one of you that's had one of my kids or somebody else's kids. I could tell you stories, but then I'd get in trouble for saying kids' names. But I mean, these teachers have loved on these kids like no other. And I don't know how else you can feel that valued. I just want you to know that you are valued very much. I thank you, the board, for coming together with them to work on that together. I appreciate all of you that you do. And I've also been asked a couple times to run for the board, and I just want the community as a whole to say, how are we treating our board members? I mean, I know this was a rough go with everything, but I know that there was also, these people were treated poorly during this whole thing just because they're on the board. I mean, they volunteered a lot of time. I know they get paid to be on here, but I also know that 9 times out of 10, they donate that money right back to the school. I just want us to remember what an awesome community this is. It is. Thank you all for not leaving. Thank you all for, you know, sticking around and continuing this out. And I just really, I mean, I think that, I know that's hard, but we're going to look back on this in a couple of years and I don't remember how much that sucked. and be like, look at where we're at now. I really believe that that's the case. So I will, I just want to say that. Thank you again.
Next up, and with that, I only had two cards. Do you have something, Karen?
Me?
Yeah. Well, normally you have something. I was just.
I thought about that. Is Jen doing it? Oh, Jen did. But you know what? I was thinking about it because the staff has really worked hard.
Yeah.
I mean, their main.
Well, we can do it.
It's all right. No, but. I really want to say that they really worked hard during this time, and it may not seem like it to some people, but they really care about the kids, and I think that's what it all comes down to.
Yeah, I want to echo that. You know, I got two beautiful daughters, and you know, there's a couple of teachers out here that work with Adam, Jen, and I know you had a big impact. I don't want to talk about it today, but so it's been rough at our house too, Stephanie, so it's like, it's not just the little kids, it's the big kids. My baby's 20 years old, so we had that conversation. I'm glad it's over with. I want to thank everybody from the teachers to the helpers to the librarians to everybody on my board. I'm just glad it's over with, and hopefully it's a big learning lesson for everybody. And hopefully we'll move on, and next time it won't go through this way. We went through what we had to go through because it wasn't good for anybody. Now we can heal and go forward. Anybody else on the board have anything? That's the last of the comment cards I have.
Just to echo, I'm a huge parchment supporter. Anybody that knows me or follows me, you won't hear me say negative about the district. You won't hear me say negative about anybody. I'm just not that way. What I love is what I saw on Friday. I don't know how many of you attended the Hall of Fame game at high school. Not only was it time that we recognized people in our Hall of Fame that had been here for, whether it was athletics or even, you know, past superintendents, we recognized that, which is always amazing. I also saw we do have an athlete that has a sick mother, and when I mean sick, it's, and we had came together, all the kids had wear pink, we wear pink, we raise money. That's what we do well. That's why I'm here. We do people and relationships very well. I wish more people would talk to us, the board, talk to principals, talk to admins, maybe stay off the Facebook, stay off the posting, talk to people, look at the
second that one. Then, yeah.
Look me in the eye, call me, talk to me, meet me, talk to me somewhere. I think that's what makes us great. So the boys won a conference this year. We haven't won conference in 1989, the basketball boys. If anybody's got an update, let me know. The girls are playing districts tonight.
Right now.
In Penfield, and we're hoping they have a shot there. So I think everybody, it is hard. It was extremely hard. I want to get back to what we do really well, which is we're all here for one reason. I believe the teacher and the admins who support the kids. So I thank everybody. So
that's good. Next regular meeting is going to be Monday, March 26th, 7 at the middle school. We do have the work session on Wednesday, May 2nd. That was a unanimous, that's for labor relations. Other than that, we are adjourned.